Hi YouTube! Remember when phones used to be small? Well, those times are definitely over, because today I want to show you the HTC Galaxy Note i9220 phone that I just received from fastcartech.com. When you order it, it comes with a wall charger. It comes in a pretty white box. A USB data cable. Fastcartech also included a European plug adapter. Comes with two batteries, one is obviously in the phone already. Some earphones, some extra earplugs, a screen protector, some absolutely useless paperwork, and it also comes with an additional back cover with a leather front, which is very cool. This phone has a 5.3 capacitive 5-point multi-tap screen with a 480x800 pixel resolution. It has a MT6573 CPU inside, which is clocked at approximately 650 MHz. I believe it has 512 MB ROM and RAM, and it also supports TF cards up to whatever. It runs on Android 2.3 Gingerbread. It is a quad band, so it'll operate all over the world, and it also supports 3G/UMTS in one of the SIM slots. It has Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, GPS, it also supports AGPS. It has a G sensor, a light sensor, a proximity sensor, and it even has a magnetic field sensor, so you can use it as a compass. It has two cameras, one front-facing camera with a 1.2 megapixel output, and one main camera with a 8 megapixel output, which also supports autofocus, which is important for barcode scanning, and it also has a LED flashlight. But most importantly, this phone is a dual SIM, dual standby phone, so you can operate it with two SIM cards at the same time. Let's take a quick look at the buttons and everything. You have a physical home button right here, a menu and back soft touch button right there. This is your microphone, and this is actually quite funny. This phone also has a stylus for capacitive touchscreens. On the left side you have a volume up down rocker. On the right you have your on off button. On the back you have speakers, your main camera, your LED flashlight. And on the top you have your USB port and a headphone jack. Like always, I installed some additional apps and games. I'm going to show you the stock launcher, but I'm also going to show you some alternative launchers, like my favorite one, the SVB Shell 3D launcher, as you can see already. Have fun! Thank you.
Thank you.